Okay, so I'm really, really excited to be here at the NRF Big Show, especially on a special day like today, right? Today is Martin Luther King Day. It's a special day for all of us to celebrate also a great American hero. And what better way to talk about retail? So for me, I've spent my entire career in the technology industry. Now, I'll share a secret with you. I've also worked in retail. Growing up in high school and in college, during Christmas especially, you could get jobs in retail because it was so busy. And so I remember checking people out at JCPenney's. I'm sure if any of you are out there that I checked out, I bet you I did it wrong. So I apologize right now. So I arrived in the technology industry before the PC, and I watched the PC transform the world. And not only the world of technology, but the world around us and the world of retail and everywhere around us. And I believe that once again, we're at another juncture where technology is going to make a big shift in the world. And that is that everything is becoming smart and connected. Everything around us. You are becoming smart and connected. Everything you interact with in your day is becoming smart and connected. If we apply that to retail, really technology is changing the way we shop, the way we enjoy products. Even the definition of what a store is being changed by technology. And with that, technology is generating tremendous amounts of data, giving really a rise to robust analytics, helping retailers understand their business in much, much deeper ways. It's also changing the way consumer expectations and preferences occur. Every single element of what we call retail today is undergoing a transformation. And of course, like with every transformation, there is great opportunity. And that's what we're going to talk about today, is that it's not something to avoid. It's an opportunity. Today, I'm going to talk about the retail transformation that is underway and how at Intel we are thinking about it. Then we're going to talk about the opportunities to use that technology to transform your business and to take advantage of this unprecedented shift in retail that we see. And for those who know me or have seen me before, it's not going to just be a bunch of talk. I'm not a foil flipper. I don't like standing up here and just talking. We're going to do live demos. Every demo you see here will be live. And every demo you see here is a product that is available to impact your retail environment today. So to start, I thought I'd talk about what is driving this incredible transformation, and that is this coming flood of data that we see. At the heart of the customer retail relationship is data. That is what people are sharing in every moment. We believe that data has become one of the most important forces in all of technology. And in fact, we've kind of labeled the term that data is the new oil. It will transform every industry. Just like more than a century ago, oil transformed the world and how industry got things done, data is that new transformation engine. It provides insights and opportunities to the retailer and to the customer. Most of the customers have already gotten and used their data before they enter that retail environment, whether that environment is online or in store. Online retailers have known this for several years now and taken advantage of it. As you go across the internet and you scan and look at different things that you want to potentially purchase, they see that. They see your behavior. If you put something into your shopping cart and then you choose never to actually purchase it, they see exactly what that was. If you're in their store and you choose to buy something else, they see what you moved from. You moved from this to that, maybe a different color, a different size, a different style. They see all of that data. and they have seen that data for a year. And with that, they can access and analyze that data from anywhere in the world. Now, your retail environments produce massive amounts of data as well. At Intel, we see all of this data in a very dynamic way, and I want to show you kind of how we think about the world. We call this the virtual cycle of growth, and we drive almost everything we do at Intel through this. Now, whether it's an autonomous car or a retail environment or the latest virtual reality systems that we're inventing, everything we do, we think about in this kind of virtuous cycle. A virtuous cycle means it builds upon itself. So at the bottom are things and devices. And those things and devices can be everything from the smart watch on your body that is counting your steps and your heart rate and watching where you go and what you do, to the smart point of sale device, the smart retail outlet. Can be all of those things, your smart home. What's made those unique is connectivity. And that connectivity can be through a hard wire, it could be wireless, it can be through a 3G modem connection, all of those things. But the thing is, they're connected now. And once those devices are connected, that's when the power of that data is unleashed, because it can now be collected in the data center, the cloud, as people call it, and once it's there, it can put analytics can be applied to it. We can start to understand it. We can interpret it. All that stuff you've heard about, machine learning, right, artificial intelligence, all of that, it takes large amounts of data across a wide population. And once it's up there in the cloud, it can now be applied. Once you have those analytics, you can then push it down into those devices or all the way down to the person using those devices. And you can give them insights. You can give them interpretations of that data. You can give them predictions on what's next, right? You would be amazed at what can be predicted out of a large enough data set. Almost any behavior, any attribute can be predicted. The question is, how big is the data set and how accurate do you want to be? That's what we see as this virtuous cycle. And every industry, we believe, will be transformed by this. And you can see this in autonomous cars. It takes large numbers of cars being connected. It goes up into the cloud. The machine learning is applied. We can now start to understand how cars and drivers behave. And we can start to push that down in the car, and the car can drive itself. I was in Germany yesterday driving an autonomous car around Munich. Same thing at retail. We can start to predict what your customers want, what they need, what they see, what's important to them. As all of these components work together in this cycle, we're able to deliver what we believe is amazing experiences. And we are developing technologies to allow you as an end user to seamlessly implement these. So rather than just talk about this, I thought we'd take a look at how this will change the retail environment and how people can benefit from this, how they can benefit from this virtuous cycle. So we believe this coming flood of data is going to have three impacts into the retail environment. First is going to be around reinventing the in-store experience. We're going to show you some great examples of that today, how the whole in-store experience can be changed through this data set. Second is how you can then utilize the analytics that we just talked about. And then finally is creating what we call the store of the future. How do you pull all of this together? How do you get all of those analytics in a simple, seamless way, connected and secure, so that you can now do this? So, all the slides aside, let's get into the real data now. Let's start with creating memorable customer experiences. So there's a lot of ways retailers today create very memorable customer experiences. That could be superb service, you know, the eye-popping merchandise people talk about, perfect product displays. We all spend a lot of time, and there's an art to that. But when tech companies look at that, when we look at that customer experience, we ask another question. How can we create experiences that give the customer more control, that it's now their experience, that they're the designers of this experience? They get to do what they want to do. And then how does the retailer, out of that creation, get more information, more data? So we've started to see things like virtual reality and powerful analytics come together. We're going to show you some great examples of that today. Virtual reality, as you see, has been kind of coming onto the marketplace now for the last, I don't know, year or two. And it's a big focus of ours at Intel. And if you were at CES, we did a 260 press conference, the whole thing in virtual reality. People spent the majority of their time in the virtual reality world. You're already seeing it transform things like gaming. If you've played a virtual reality game, it changes your whole experience. Sports. Sports is about to be transformed through virtual reality. Imagine watching a sporting event from the eyes of the quarterback, the whole game. 2 years from now, that's the world we'll see. So what I want to show you today is how virtual reality can get into the retail experience. And I want to emphasize that these are not beta tests of what's possible years in the future. Everything that we're going to show you is happening at the leading edge of retail right now. So I happened to be in China in November, and I met with Alibaba, who's really one of the leading innovative tech companies and one of the largest online retailers in the world. Now, they created November 11th. They call it Singles Day, 11-11, all ones. And it's a day to give yourself presents. It's an amazing concept, right? And it's very much similar to Black Friday in the US, only much, much bigger. It's also the biggest day of e-commerce for Alibaba. Now, during Singles Day 2016, they used virtual reality to engage their customers and immerse them in a shopping experience in brick-and-mortar retail. So an onliner used virtual reality to give them a brick-and-mortar experience. So I'd like to invite Mark on stage here to give us a look of just what Alibaba did. Hey, Mark. Welcome to NRF.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
So why don't you show us what Alibaba did?
Yeah, exactly. So what I have here is just a standard regular smartphone, and I've loaded the Alibaba app, and this can be run on basically any sort of current model smartphone today. So you fire up the application, and then you just have to use this small little adapter to give you sort of a stereoscopic experience. So if I snap it in here like this, I'm instantly transported to a store somewhere in the world. Now, I happen to have a cable coming off here, and this is really just to give the audience the ability to see sort of what I'm seeing, not in stereoscopic, but at least a 2D vision of that. So if you see on the screen now, you actually see what I'm seeing here. And here I am in a department store, and I can look around, see the different display cases. I can move through the store. And if I see something that maybe catches my eye, I can turn over and maybe look a little bit closer at it. You know, that red cookware set is something my wife has been wanting to get for some time. So I can even go ahead and purchase it right there online. So it's quite an amazing experience. It's easy to use. Oh, and it's upside down.
Just to show you it's live. We're not kidding.
It is live. So there, if you guys can pull it up again just to show, sorry about the upside down experience. There we go. Okay.
Why don't you buy it again, Mark?
So I just want you guys to know that it was right side up for me, so everything looked good. Sorry about that. But so the idea here is obviously it's a simple, basic application, but it's very rich. It's 3D. And the idea is there's millions of devices out there in consumers' hands today that can have these types of experiences, amazing retail experiences that anybody can create.
Thanks a lot for showing us that, Mark.
Thanks, Brian.
So Alibaba did that in November. That was a store here in New York. So a Chinese online retailer in stores in New York, using cell phones that already everybody has, a cardboard box that they ship to people that costs them a few pennies. Now imagine the number of, you know, customers that you can expose your company to using this kind of technology. This VR solution that they used was online for 11 days. Back to that 11 thing again. It attracted over 8 million users. And they, as I said, they were shopping at a store right here in New York City. So another important aspect of virtual reality is that it lets every customer create their own world at home. And you can do it at home, but you can really do it, as you saw with the device there, Mark did, really anywhere you want, including standing in your own store. So I'd like to show you what the customer will be able to do in the future. So VR is going to allow people to immerse themselves in a realistic environment and to shop wherever they want. So with virtual reality, they can choose the color, they can choose the style, all real time, while sitting in your store, but feeling like they're at home. So to show us that, I'd like to have David here show us just what's happening with virtual reality and the future of shopping. Hey, David, welcome to NRF.
Thanks, Brian.
So why don't you kind of show us what you have here and why you're in a green box?
Oh, sure, definitely. Well, I'm going to show you actually how virtual reality can be used as a tool to help enhance the way your customers experience your products. And this tool is Shopper MX by InContext Solutions. And this green box, that's just actually how the audience can actually see what I'm seeing. That you don't actually need this for virtual reality. It's just for you. Just you right there, right? So with that, let's actually get into it. And now I'm in my home. It's been beautifully captured and modeled by a professional content service. You can see my dining room over there. You can see my kitchen. But really, I'm going to focus on the living room because I'm in the market for a new sofa. You know, I have a really contemporary style, and the system knows that based on my preferences. So the recommendation engine has placed this sofa right here, and it's going to see if I like it. I like it, but I really am open to options as well. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and take a look and cycle through something like this nice blue and gray one or this red and black. But I did like the one that it recommended. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and put that in my basket, and just like that, it's on its way to my home. So you can see, this is really going to open a whole new frontier to engage your customers. Retailers can place products into this world, and customers can experience the products in a whole new way.
Yeah, I can see how it completely transformed the retail experience. Thanks a lot for showing us that.
Sure.
So, as we said, this system is available today, and you can see how in your store, your customer can have a very different experience. And again, you're going to get data about what they're looking at, what styles they like, what colors they're looking for, what's interesting to them, what do they put in that shopping cart, but then take out at the end of the day and don't quite purchase. All of that data is available. And this solution is only one way virtual reality can be used in the retail environment. So you can imagine the possibilities moving forward. So now, what if we used virtual reality to help retailers imagine the stores themselves? Imagine using virtual reality to change the aisles and to think about the aisles in your store without having to actually do the work to change them yourselves first, and actually think about it from an analytics standpoint. So I'd like to go back to David, and he's going to show us just how you can do that. Hey, David, welcome back.
Hey, never left. So, Brian, so we're actually going to show you three ways of how we can improve the store plan. First is the planogram. Many of you are very familiar with planograms, have been doing it for years, but we're going to take that into virtual reality. So let's take a look at that. Here we go. Now, I'm standing in front of my aisle. It's full of snacks. And you know what? This month, I think I'm going to change it to cereal. So what I'm going to do is go quickly, change that out. And just like that, I now have an aisle full of cereal. And I'm standing in front of it, just like my customers will be, and seeing what they're seeing. So it's really cool. And you know what? This is something that Walgreens is doing today. And in fact, I'm actually in a Walgreens store right now, changing out their planograms, so hopefully they like that. Second point I wanted to make was the ability to use predictive analytics. And what that is it's going to help me determine what the customer will see naturally notice in the first 3 to 5 seconds as they glance across the shelf. So what I'm going to do is turn on the heat map. As you can see, here in the darker orange areas is where it's going to highly likely grab your customer's attention. So remember that. Third point here I'm going to make is that I can overlay actual sales data and put that onto the planogram so we can take a look at the top 10 sales, or I could look at the bottom 10% of sales. And you know, remembering that heat map, I can decide maybe I need to move a product that's not performing as well, so let me just make some room here and place the lower performing somewhere that is going to get the customer's attention. So you see, this is a way that many actual retailers and brand partners have seen an ROI of $16 in operational cost savings for every dollar spent on the Shopper MX solution. So reaching the optimal store configuration is how you're going to reach that cost and time savings. And it's right side up as well.
Thanks a lot, David.
You're welcome.
So we've tried to show you just a couple of examples here of how virtual reality can change the consumer's point of view and you as a retailer, how you can use it to really optimize your retail environment and give the shopper new experiences. It's amazing to us how the power of VR and data analytics can come together to actually transform the aisle as well. And you can think about how you can optimize your overall profitability as you think about what products you're placing and where. And that's really going to transform how retailers think about configuring their stores. So virtual reality is just the tip of the iceberg. The store of the future will continue, we believe, to evolve for many years to come. The next transformational change in retail is, again, the incredible set of insights driven by these analytics. Online retailers have, as I said earlier, they've been collecting this incredibly rich amount of data since their humble beginnings. And you can see how it's driven their insights and their real targeting of customers in a much different way. They know what items consumers look at, what they put in their cart, what they don't buy. All of that information is captured when you're an online retailer. And some of the devices we've shown you here can actually help you capture that. But what we're here today to talk to you about is the full suite of options for you to do this. One of the things that's changing is now any type of retailer, we believe, can take full advantage of this incredible set of data and can be unleashed. We know that retailers who use data and data analytics to transform their stores will have an advantage in this industry. We believe at Intel it's going to separate out those retailers who make it to the next transformational step and those who don't. Those who grab the data, those who adopt it, those who embrace it, those will be the ones that really flourish in this next generation of retail. Deployed in the right way, data analytics will tell you exactly what customers are buying, what they want, and how to keep precise and fast-moving inventory, all in real time. I've already mentioned that sensors can be added around the store, but what if you had a robot? What if you had a robot that could go through your store and could feed your associates the data they needed? I'd like to introduce to you Tally, the new robot. Thank you. now welcome Brad Nagolia and Cindy Robotics and Tally, the robot.
Brian,
hey, Brad.
For having us.
Tally needs to come out. Come on, Tally.
I have network connectivity. Come on, Tally. Don't be shy.
She's shy today.
Started.
Okay, so hey, can you tell us a little bit about what Tally is doing to solve some of the big problems in retail?
Sure, of course. The big challenge we see in retail today is there's a data gap. Traditional brick and mortar retailers don't always understand their true state of merchandise in their stores. And that costs the retail industry billions of dollars every year, as well as affects the customer experience. You know, today, retailers spend countless hours every week auditing their shelves, only really achieving limited results. With the latest advancements in technology, we knew there was a better way, and that's really why we built Tally.
So maybe you can tell us how Tally works.
Of course.
If you just come out here.
Sure. So Tally is a fully autonomous mobile robot. It's designed to work during normal store hours alongside customers and shoppers. It does not require any infrastructure changes to the store. And it works by going up and down the store aisles, much like you saw in the video. And it captures high fidelity imagery of the store shelves, which we then process from a computer vision and machine learning perspective to look for three key things. Is product stocked? Is it in the right place? And does it have the right price? We then provide those insights back to the retailer's supply chain or workforce management system to drive greater in-store operations. So Tally itself is empowered by an Intel CPU. It gets about 12 hours of battery life and it will dock when it needs to recharge all by itself. On the side of the robot, we have a series of cameras that allows us to analyze the state of merchandise on the shelf. You'll see the cameras here. And it looked like we had network connectivity problems, so excuse us. On the front of the robot, you have a friendly display that helps folks understand what the robot is doing in the environment. And in the screen behind me in the moment, if it comes up, you will see Tally's view of the world. And the challenge in building a robot in the retail space wasn't so much in identifying the products on the shelf or decoding a barcode or a shelf tag. It was developing a cost-effective solution that could operate safely and naturally in a retail environment alongside customers and shoppers. So to do that, we use a number of sensor technology, including Intel's RealSense 3D camera, LiDAR, advanced IMU. And you can see here, you can see my silhouette. So this allows us to clearly depict elements such as shopping carts, a case pack of product, a piece of clothing that may be on the ground, et cetera, and allowing the robot to operate safely in the environment.
So my always question about technology like this, when is it available?
Sure. So we announced Tally to the market about a year ago. Since then, we've been doing a number of select trials with top retailers across the mass market, grocery, drug, and value space, as well as partnering with a number of the brands with the data we collect.
Okay. So available soon.
Soon.
All right. Thanks a lot for showing us
Brian.
Tally, Brad. Always one of our biggest issues in a big environment like this with everybody on their phones and all is network connectivity. So that was a great example of, again, it's a real-time demonstration. So I think Tally is a great example of how a robot can improve and really give you that real-time insight into data and data analytics about your entire supply chain as a retailer. And it could go around and be collecting that data all the time. Now, the value of data doesn't stop at the storefront's door. The distribution center is oftentimes a critical spot for both data, data collection, and decision making, right? Getting the right product, getting it to the customer, getting it to the store, all of that is critical. Many of our warehouse management systems are automated today. However, there's always room for, we believe, more operational improvements. Advances in technology such as artificial intelligence can offer really repetitive tasks to be automated. And now you no longer have to worry about mistakes and human error. When paired with hardware that employees already use, these solutions can help improve shipment verification accuracy and save time, labor, and money. Let's have Chelsea show us just one example of how these kinds of solutions can be applied to the warehouse. Hey, Chelsea.
Hey, Brian.
So, welcome to NRF. What do you have here?
I'm showing you a vision picking application today that's using the Recon Jet Pro hardware and the UbiMax XPIC software. So the Recon Jet Pro enables a connected workforce by providing relevant information directly to a worker entirely hands-free. So what you're seeing up there on the screen is actually what I'm seeing right here on my display. Now, we expect workers to be wearing these glasses all day. And to that end, comfort is paramount. So we've designed the glasses to be perfectly balanced and lightweight. Now, we've actually been testing these glasses in Intel's own warehouses, and we've seen that using vision picking, we're able to improve efficiency of workers in a warehouse, as well as decrease their error rate. But that's enough of me talking about it. Why don't I show you how it works?
That'd be great.
All right, so imagine I'm a warehouse worker. I take my badge and I log in for the day. What you'll see is that I'm provided my first item on my pick list immediately. What I need to pick is a box of books, and then I see that it's going to be in the upper left-hand corner of my shelves. So there we go, box of books. I scan it, and it's confirmed as the right item by changing color. Now I'm told I need to put this in order A. Take my box, scan order A, and I moved on to my next item because everything worked perfectly. Now, the question really is, what happens when it doesn't work? So what happens when I have a problem? Here I see I'm picking staples, and they're going to be in the upper left-hand corner of my shelves. And I walk over and I see there are actually two labels, and I'm not really sure which one's right. I scan the bottom one, and I'm told immediately that it's the incorrect item. It's oil, it's not staples. When I scan staples, I'm allowed to move forward into the next step. The same is true for bins. This way, I know that I'll never put the wrong item in the wrong order. Here I scanned bin C, incorrect. Bin B fixes it. Now, this is just one example of how the Recon Jet Pro is changing the way we work. If you're interested in learning more about us, we're actually up in the iLabs for the rest of NRF, so come check us out. And I know your last question is always, how are you able to buy them? We're actually selling online. We've been out for the last year. So check us out at reconinstruments.com.
All right, thanks a lot, Chelsea. That was a great example. So we truly believe this is a great and innovative way to improve the efficiency, affect retailers' bottom line, and remember, customer satisfaction as well. Having the right parts in your store, getting the right parts to the customer, all of those things are critical, and this can really reduce the error rate, but also they increase the efficiency and speed at which all of these operations can be done. So the solutions we've shown you so far allow your associates to focus on what's most important, really the customer. No longer are you having to worry about shelf stocking or back off warehouse work. You're really automating all of that so decisions are made and are transferred out to the retail storefront and allowing the retailers to really focus much more on the customers. We're excited to see, we believe, the possibilities of these types of technology to improve every aspect of your store. Now, so far, we've talked about how the leading edge technology can improve the in-store experience, but I'd like to think much, much bigger if we can for a little bit. So what if technology could help you reimagine the entire retail store from end to end? We talked about earlier the advantage that online retailers have over brick and mortar, the complete insight in what the customer does. And that's something that we've been working at Intel to bring to every retailer. What if we could gather the same insights and respond to customer needs real time while they're actually in the store? What if you could get that kind of analytics and insight real time? The vision of the responsive retail is what Intel and our partners will make possible. We have developed what we call the Intel Responsive Retail Platform, and it's an integration of multiple data streams to really connect the physical and digital worlds together in the retail environment across the entire enterprise. With this platform, you're able to have 360-degree coverage of your store and collect and analyze data real time. You can gather real-time insights to fully understand the shopper's behaviors. And you can adopt end-to-end security and provide protection, detection, and correction to your retail environment, real-time. Now, we want to make this seamless customer experience a reality, but we can't do this alone. We've had to collaborate with retail industry to integrate this technology solutions and truly what we believe level the playing field when it comes to customer visibility. So we're excited that we've been able to collaborate with two great partners in supply chain. JDA is a leader, leading retail planning and workforce management solutions. They recognize that the responsive retail platform, they can transform previously disconnected data streams into dynamic merchandising tasks for store associates and improve truly inventory management to increase that customer satisfaction. Customers want to be in your store and they want to buy. What they want to buy isn't there, that's a missed opportunity. SAP is a leader in enterprise application software. They see the value in unifying the capabilities of the responsive retail platform with the HANA platform to build customer enterprise applications to optimize the needs of retailers. But again, I don't want to stand here with just a bunch of foils. I want to actually show you this technology and the solutions it provides in action. So, we have Mary over here in our responsive retail platform, and she's going to walk us through just what this system is capable. Hi, Mary.
Hi, Brian. Thanks so much. Here we have BuyReveal. BuyReveal is a pop-up shop that's focused on enabling retail as a service and bringing retail direct to customers wherever they may be. Additionally, we've outfitted this with Intel's responsive retail platform so that retailers can really understand exactly what's going on in terms of their customers and their products. BuyReveal itself is similar to a brick and mortar store in that it has room for hanging items, storage, and shelving. Additionally, the doors open up to enable fitting rooms, as we have here on the left, and close at night for safety and security. We've enabled this with Intel's responsive retail platform, which allows us to understand customer and product data. Using the overhead cameras and working with one of our partners, Retail Next, we're really able to understand customers and exactly where they're engaging within the store. All of this is shown on a heat map here. We can see exactly where customers are within the store, where they're spending their time, so that you can make better decisions. Additionally, when we look at this over a longer period of time and couple it with things like POS data, we're able to have operational dashboards so that you can make better decisions. Using information from Intel's responsive retail sensors, we're also able to see product information. Working with one of our other partners, Detego, we've enabled a responsive fitting room. We'll take a tour of that now. As soon as we walk into the fitting room, we can see that Intel's responsive sensors pick up on the items that we brought in. Here, I can select each item, size up, size down, or request assistance. Additionally, there's the ability to cross-sell or upsell, depending on what you're trying to do. This is really allowing customers and sales associates to have a more dynamic conversation and make sure that we're delivering what customers want when they want it. We can also see additional data similar to e-commerce. So the same way that you can see cart abandonment, here we're able to see when people bring things into the fitting room and then don't actually purchase them. That allows retailers to make better, more informed decisions. All of this information goes up into Intel's responsive retail platform, which allows retailers to make better decisions, increasing operational efficiency, and improving customer service.
Okay, when is it available?
It's available now.
Thanks, Mary. That was an incredible display. I really appreciate you showing us this technology.
Thanks.
So you can imagine how that can scale. We showed you on a very like kiosk type platform with BuyReveal, but it can scale really to any size. And with that data and understanding what's going into the changing room, for example, you're able to understand your customer much, much better. Suppose that's a loyal customer and you have their buying history. And you can suggest things that they've already bought that could go with the items that they brought into the changing room. Or you may be able to suggest things that they don't have or you don't think they have and that would go well with what they brought into the changing room. All of that is information now and analytics that can happen real time that can change both the customer experience but also your experience as well. What you just saw was a great example of that, we believe. And I'm sure you're thinking, okay, it has potential, but can I scale that to fit the much larger stores, much larger enterprise operation that I run? I'm here to tell you that it's absolutely the technology that can scale end to end with any store, with any size operation. In fact, we've already started a robust experiment to create the store of tomorrow with one of the most iconic American retailers, Levi Strauss. To tell us more about this, I'd like you to welcome on stage Executive Vice President and President of Global Retails of Levi's, Carrie Osk. Hey, Carrie. Welcome to NRF. So, hey, maybe you could tell us a little bit about, you know, what your thoughts on the retail industry of today are and what things like the responsive retail platform really bring and could impact this industry.
Well, thanks for having us, Brian. In-store inventory insights, specifically shelf-level in-stocks and accurate inventories are an age-old problem for retail. And while we've had inventory management and planning systems for some time, they're typically limited to telling us whether an item is in the store, but not whether it's on the sales floor and its designated location on the sales floor. In addition, what the system says for inventory is often inaccurate. Most of us have experienced this firsthand as a consumer. Imagine for a moment you just got invited to a big event tomorrow night, maybe dinner with Richard Branson. So you head out and you are looking for that perfect item, and then you see it right there in a window, in a sign, or on a mannequin. You find a sales associate and they say, "Oh yes, it's right over here, follow me." And as you're walking with them across the sales floor, you see it again. It's perfect. But turns out they don't have your size on the sales floor. The sales associate says, "No problem, let me see if we have another one," and grabs a handheld, uses their radio or POS to do a stock check. "Looks like we have another one, I'll be right back." And your hopes begin to rise, only to falter when they come back empty-handed. Turns out they couldn't find it, even though the system said they had one. The truth is, full stop, this happens all the time. And as a retailer and as an industry, we can no longer accept this. Lack of shelf-level inventory in stocks and inaccurate inventories are an Achilles heel for us. And in the bad old days, the consumer didn't have very many choices. And they could either keep looking and keep shopping, maybe go to a competitor, or they had to settle for a substitute item, waiting for it to come back in stock, or to go without. But consumers don't have to settle anymore. Our team recently had some aha moments as we traveled around the world and spent considerable time with consumers in our stores and surveyed their purchase intent and purchase behavior. Now, while store traffic is declining, we discovered something else, something we think is fundamentally different about store traffic today. You see, we discovered purchase intent of consumers visiting stores is rising. Makes sense. They don't have to go to a store anymore. So when they do, their intention is higher. In addition, we found that out of stock and couldn't find my item are the top barriers to purchase for consumers that plan to make a purchase, as well as consumers who purchased but didn't get everything they wanted. We realize the opportunity and the stakes are higher now, not lower. On the opportunity side, we were underestimating the potential within our store traffic to drive sales and conversion. And as it goes along the stakes side, we also realized
that when we're out of stock, not only do we lose in the moment the opportunity to drive a planned or impulse purchase, but a frustrated and disappointed consumer may decide that the trip and their time and their energy wasn't worth it, potentially jeopardizing future traffic as well. That's why we're excited about working with Intel.
So you guys were our original test customer in all of this. Can you tell us why it made sense to really integrate this technology into the Levi's stores?
We're proud to be on the leading edge of this project with Intel, and our teams are working together right now to pilot this technology in several of our stores. So first, what is it? The goal is real-time, all-the-time inventory insights, which brings several benefits. First, our sales floor replenishment processes are triggered earlier and more accurately, increasing the likelihood that consumers will find their item on the sales floor in their size and their color in its designated location. This frees up our store teams to shift their focus to the consumer and away from inventory management. It also gives our planning and allocation teams more accurate information to guide inventory decisions. It all starts with RFID tags on all the product in our stores. Ceiling-mounted sensors detect the product's location and help us understand inventory levels, in-stocks, and trigger replenishment actions. Those ceiling-mounted sensors also detect when a product is moving, which has eliminated the need for hand scanning and strict process guidelines. We're excited about progressing with you to the next stage of testing, where we'll rigorously measure the results and benefits of this program against control stores without the technology.
So that's good. So you're on the leading edge, you're starting to expand. Maybe you could tell us a little bit about how this solution, the responsive retail platform, has really started to eliminate complexity from your business and give you the insights that you guys need to really drive your business better.
Well, we remain very excited about the partnership. These solutions simplify in-store inventory management, freeing teams to focus on the consumer and improving the accuracy of information used to make decisions. These tools can be used by any retailer with physical stores. One of our goals at Levi Strauss & Company is to become a leading omni-channel brand, partner, and retailer across our 50,000 points of distribution and over 2,200 branded stores, including 700 owned and operated, as well as Levi.com. Our thanks to you, Brian, and your team. We appreciate the talent, expertise, and dedication in helping us and other retailers address a real need for our industry. This, we believe, will put us in a position of strength as we all strive to drive sales and conversion in a rapidly evolving environment and deliver a truly remarkable experience for our consumers.
Fantastic story. I really want to thank you for coming on stage and telling us this story from your words. Thanks, Carrie. So there you have it. If you wondered whether that technology could scale and really drive a difference in a retailer's results, I think Carrie gave great proof that this technology, this capability is for real. Today, I'm excited to announce that over the next 5 years, Intel is planning to invest $100 million in a retail industry with our responsive retail platform. That $100 million, we believe, along with this platform, will be revolutionary. It will drive a much deeper understanding of how each element of the store and the customer in it are interacting. It will give retail customers that data, those insights that online retailers have had for years. And we're excited to see this grow and expand. As Carrie said, traffic may be down, but intent is actually higher. I personally have seen that myself within my own family and my friends. I truly believe this, and we believe this fund will actually help implement this and accelerate this. This investment will focus on the responsive retail platform to allow you as retailers to deploy the hardware and software in your stores. I invite you to visit the Intel booth for more information on this system and to get a firsthand experience in the responsive retail platform that Mary showed you. Again, we believe that retailers are on the cusp of transformation, and it's never been more exciting to be in retail. Technology is going to enable retailers to have a deep end-to-end understanding of their environments and use this information to develop new ways to engage with customers. I hope this morning I've shown you creative, innovative ways that leading-edge retailers are using technology and data to get to their customers and make it a more satisfying experience. The companies that are using data to their advantage are thriving in the retail industry. We want to collaborate with you to deliver a seamless customer experience while growing your business. I really hope you're able to capitalize on this intersection of retail and technology to revolutionize the retail industry. I look forward to coming back next year and hearing about the great success stories and having another discussion with you about where technology can help you grow your businesses. I really want to thank you for allowing me the stage this morning, and have a great NRF the rest of this week. Thank you.